You heard a lot about it during the 2016 election, the Bernie Sanders Health Care for All plan.
That's right, a truly universal health care program that dispenses with private insurance as we know it. Of course, Republicans are in charge, and with billions of dollars on the line, some would call this one dead on arrival. But for Bernie Sanders, it's all about building momentum.
By dubbing his plan Medicare for All, Bernie Sanders reminds people we already have a single-payer system that covers millions of seniors and has functioned for decades.
And not to continue a system which allows insurance companies and drug companies to make hundreds of billions of dollars in profits each year.
The Sanders rollout was like a who's who of potential Democratic presidential nominees, Kamala Harris, Elizabeth Warren, Cory Booker, just to name a few.
I cannot sit when Australia or Canada or England takes care of every one of their children better than the United States of America.
As for Minnesota senators, Amy Klobuchar's not on board. Al Franken says we need to fix the Affordable Care Act first, but he did sign on to Sanders' bill as a co-sponsor, taking to Facebook to say, like Paul Wellstone, I've always believed that health care is a right for all Americans, not a privilege, and that every person in our country deserves access to the care they need.
The consolidation of health care in the hands of the federal government from cradle to grave.
The standard conservative raps against single payer, one, it's a government program and government can't do anything as well as the private sector. Two, you don't want Uncle Sam getting between you and your doctor. Three, Medicare already doesn't pay doctors enough for what they do. And four, government's already broke, so how can we afford it?
I can't think of anything worse than having government be more involved in your healthcare instead of less involved.
We spend almost twice as much per capita on healthcare as any other nation on earth, and yet we have 28 million people without any health insurance, and even more who are underinsured.
Single-payer boosters say Americans and their employers already shell out boatloads of cash on insurance premiums and out-of-pocket costs, so why not cut out the middleman and send some of those dollars instead to a national plan without a built-in profit motive?
The average American family will be much better off financially than under the current system, because you will no longer be writing checks to private insurance companies.
Not only does the president not support it, but America doesn't support it, or Bernie Sanders would be sitting in the Oval Office right now.
Well, Bernie Sanders is the first to admit, as does Al Franken, that something like this won't happen in the United States for some time to come. But they're hoping to build support from the ground up, kind of tap into grassroots movements that are already out there. And the timing, of course, is very decent right now because Washington's all tied up in knots over how to fix an expensive and complicated system. So Bernie's not going away. And you know, one of the big issues that still has to be resolved is who's going to decide if you had single payer, how much the doctors and hospitals are paid for what they do, because right now that's an unknown.
Will we still have a copay with this?
Well, I think they can design it so that people who can afford to pay or people that are under 65 could still contribute to their health care, but not design it in such a way that anybody's iced out as they are now.
So we watch and wait.
That's right.
All right.